Yaskawa.
You're watching the PLC Open Part 4 Coordinated Motion video tutorial series. This video shows how to blend linear moves. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier. Here's a quick preview of what's to come. Stopping at each corner in a sequence of linear moves may be required in some applications, but this same approximate path can also be accomplished with rounded off corners and one continuous motion. This is achieved using the inputs for buffer mode, transition mode, and transition parameters. We'll modify the existing sequence to blend these moves together. To follow along in this tutorial, you do need the class project called PLCO4 Training, and you need that project running on the MP3300 IEC demo. The controller must be configured for a 2D gantry with the triangular path programmed, as shown in the previous videos. Be sure you're running MotionWorks IEC version 3.2 or higher, and that the controller firmware is version 3.2 or higher. If you would like remote access to an MP3300 IEC and Sigma 7 demo, please request by email to training@yaskawa.com. You can see how this works in the remote connection e-learning video. In the previous video, we sequenced together three linear moves, stopping in between in order to create this triangular profile. Now, this motion may be suitable for some applications, say cutting along the path or drilling at the endpoint. However, with an application like gluing, one continuous motion would be required. PLC Open Part 4 supports this with what we call blending of movements. We can program the gantry to trace out the same path, starting this time at point D, rounding off the corners at constant speed in one continuous motion until returning to the start point. Smooth corners between linear moves can be achieved by setting the function block parameters for buffer mode, and transition parameter in all of the moves except the first move. This means that subsequent moves must be buffered, that is, to execute each move before the previous move is done. Now in MotionWorks IEC, let's look at this buffer mode input by right-clicking for the help. And buffer mode is the same MC buffer mode enumerated data type that we're familiar with from PLC Open Part 1. And just as a quick review, this is for buffering multiple moves together or for blending the speed profiles between different moves. But creating a smooth profile between two vector paths will require not just a blending of speeds, but also a blending of direction. So let me go back here with Alt left arrow. PLC Open Part 4 defines several transition modes and transition parameters available for the blending type buffer modes. We can follow the help here under the vector. And the first table I'd like to point out is actually at the bottom of this help page. Now this table lists several transition modes, such as constant velocity, corner distance, corner deviation. And notice that these transition modes only make sense, only apply when the buffer mode is set to one of the blending buffer modes. Then up at the top, for whatever transition mode you would like to use, there is a parameter in order to set limits on how that transition mode is implemented. So let's look briefly at these three major transition modes. Constant velocity rounds the corner in a circular arc, reaching the corner point as closely as possible, but with priority on achieving the desired speed. The transition parameter, therefore, is speed, given as V in this diagram. Corner distance transition mode uses a parabolic path, also reaching the corner point as closely as possible, but with a maximum limit on the distance from the corner at which this path diverges from the original. This corner distance, D, is a transition parameter. Corner deviation is similar, using the parabolic path, reaching the corner point as closely as possible. However, a maximum deviation from the corner point is defined as transition parameter E, as shown in the diagram. So which transition mode is appropriate for this example? The goal of this feature is not to define a precise path around the corner, but to create smooth and rapid motion by rounding off the corners between linear moves, just not by too much. In this example, we had wanted to maintain a constant speed, so I think constant velocity seems to be the most applicable. Now we'll program this move sequence, and the first step is to put all the moves in the correct order. Each block, except the first, must have a blending buffer mode set. We'll also have to sequence the blocks to execute when the previous block is active, instead of waiting for the previous block to be done. Finally, we'll set the chosen transition mode of constant velocity, and set the transition parameter to 100% so that the speed is maintained. Let's move over to MotionWorks IEC version 3 and implement this. So first we said we'd put everything in the right sequence. I'm going to make some room here then for point A above point B by inserting a row with control 1. And then let's go down here and grab this point A. So we have point A, point B, point C, and we do need to have one more here for point D, which we have not implemented yet. So I got to move linear absolute for gantry XY, and we'll call the position point underscore D. And for simplicity, I'll just keep the same velocity X cell and D cell. That was a control click to copy that down. All right, so we'll put the coordinates of these points in later. Looks like we have the right sequence of blocks. The next step was to set the buffer mode. And one way to do this here is go to the help. And we'll have to choose one of the buffer modes. And you know, it doesn't really matter which one of these blendings we choose because it's the same speed in all of the moves. If you have different speeds in the different moves, you can look more closely at the timing diagrams given by MC buffer mode to see how the speeds would be implemented. I'll just choose blending low, copy that over, and put that in here for buffer mode with, just paste that right in there. And I might as well do that once and for all here for all four of these blocks. Set buffer mode. I notice I have buffer mode set to blending low on the first move, and since buffer mode doesn't make any difference on the first move in a move sequence, I'll just remove that to be clear. So the next step we need to be sure about here though is that our logic flows correctly. The visual sequence is correct, but it looks like the logical sequence, this is not going to work. So we want to start the move with moving from point D to point A. So I'll move this logic up here with a cut and paste. Now for this second move to buffer with the first move and create that blended corner, we need to be sure that it executes before the previous move is done. So using done as the output will not be sufficient. The correct output to use will be active, meaning this is the current block that's controlling the axes. So we'll make a quick output here called active underscore A. And active A will execute the move to B. But since it's buffered, it won't control the motion of the axes until the previous move is done. We'll follow this same flow here by creating an active B, and we'll trigger the next move here with active B. Point C here will be active C, and we'll trigger the move to D with active C. I think I'd also like a way to move to point D at the beginning. So I'll just put a parallel contact here, call it move D. And I can force that there in the beginning for the very first time. Now for the transition mode and the transition parameter. If you remember back to the help, the data type is called MC underscore transition mode. And we had wanted the selection number 2 called officially TM constant velocity. Just going to copy that. And then we can type this one in the same as we did buffer mode, MC transition mode, pound. And I'll paste in that TM constant velocity. And then like the help showed, if you use constant velocity, you're going to have to set the velocity parameter. Let me alt left arrow back here to that transition parameter vector again. So we'll create a vector parameter, and within that array, element number 2, we'll have to put in later on here 100% if we want to keep the speed the same. So let's just make this as a local variable called transition. And later on for array element 2, we'll enter in a 100%. So now I just need to populate these to the other function blocks using control, click, and drag. Let's make this. Got 0 errors. So I'll download it. And the controller is already running from the previous exercise. So let's go to debug mode. Open up that HMI POU. Turn on toggle boolean. All right, looks like I need to enable the axes. Back up here, my logic shows that I have already set the 0 point. I've enabled the group. But before I start the move, I think I better first of all check my points. I want to add point D to the watch number 2. Here we go, watch number 2. Let's check those points here first. So point A is 0, 0. Point B is 90, 180. Point C should be 180, 0. And then point D is supposed to be 90.00. So my points are all correct. We said we had to set the transition parameter. Let's add that one to the watch window. And here's where we need to set element number 2, which corresponds to the transition mode for speed. We set that to 100.0 for 100% of the speed, just like was shown in the help here for parameters number 2. With that, I'll bring up the video window. The gantry's at point 0, 0, so first let's move to point D. And now we're at 90, 0, and stop executing. We'll be able to see this corner transition a little easier if I reduce the XLD cell to say 25.0. Now up at the top, let's start the move sequence to trace out this triangle. I'll get arranged here. Keep one eye on the positions in the watch window and the other on the motors themselves, and let's start the move. First, the move to point A at 0, 0, and without a stop, off to point B at 90, 180, and on to point C at 180, 0, and stopping at point D. This is the blended linear move. So that's it for the blended move example. We'll finish this off by zipping off a project, saving it as type zipped project, and I'll call it PLC04 blend. Zip it off. Thank you for watching this video, and remember yaskawa.com/IEC as a starting point for anything related to MotionWorks IEC and the MPIEC controllers.